Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Kirosami. If you're new here, welcome to my channel. Happy Wednesday, everybody, and welcome to another video. Today we're going to be doing another full day of keto eating. Today is my low carb day, and I have been eating in a calorie deficit for almost a month, basically a month now. It's been going a little bit over a month. It's been going really well. A lot of y'all have been still following along the challenge. Make sure y'all do check in if you are doing my 30-day calorie deficit challenge, you guys. So I'm going to be taking along my day. Like I said, I just finished at Planet Fitness. I got in a good full body workout today. I busted a sweat, and it's so humid outside because it's been raining here in Houston. It's so hot and humid, so I'm like sweaty, but it was a really good workout. I haven't ate anything. I've only been having water and staying hydrated, so we're gonna go ahead and have some breakfast today. I felt like having breakfast on the go. I didn't really feel like going home and cooking. I'm gonna go to Chick-fil-A. We're going to pick up a keto approved breakfast. I'll show y'all how to do that. Usually I get their breakfast bowl. It does come with hash brown, so I just substitute those for like extra protein. I know it's not gonna fill me up because usually it's just the bowl. They really don't have any keto approved breakfast sides, so I'll eat the bowl, and I have a protein shake at home. We'll probably have a protein shake just to hold us over, but I really felt just having like some eggs today in a little bowl, so I'm just gonna show y'all some quick options at Chick-fil-A. So let's head there. Alright, we had Chick-fil-A. I haven't been to have Chick-fil-A breakfast in a while. If y'all want to see some low calorie options at Chick-fil-A that aren't keto, let me know. I have a hair in my face. Usually I get the breakfast bowl with no hash browns. I add extra protein.
Hey, Tammy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
How's your morning going?
Going good, baby. I can't complain too much. What are we gonna get this morning?
Okay, I'm gonna eat here. Okay. I just want the bowl, but with grilled chicken, no hash browns, extra eggs, extra chicken. And then I just want a small half diet, lemonade half diet tea, or unsweet tea, and then just a small water. I'm thirsty.
Yes. All right. How are you today, Sammy?
Good. I just got in a workout.
Good.
Yeah. Ray's been working nights, so he's at home asleep. So I was like, I'm going to eat breakfast.
I'll give you the
peaceful. Yeah. I was like, I didn't feel like cooking breakfast today, so I was like, I'm going to go get some Chick-fil-A. All right, guys, I ordered my food. I look rough. I did not realize how rough I look. Okay, you can tell that I worked up a sweat. But I got my bowl. So for the most part, like, my keto options is usually the bowl, but I do have a video on separate keto options. It's an older video, but I'll pop it up here for y'all to look at. I do have more keto breakfast. I don't know if it was that much more, but there is a few that keto options that are breakfast in that video, and then I also have lunch options for y'all to enjoy. So I'll pop up that older video here from Chick-fil-A. But for the most part, I do get the bowl if it's breakfast, just extra chicken, extra eggs, just so it can be more filling. And then I also do get the jalapeno salsa because it's so good. And then I just got some water because I was super thirsty. And for my drink, I usually get half diet lemonade, half unsweet tea. The lemonade is pretty sweetened, so it's like a lightly sweetened drink. It's not like overpowering, but it's so good if I'm just wanting a different option to drink. But I do have low calorie options at Chick-fil-A that aren't keto, but they're lower calorie, higher carb, but they're still healthy. For those of y'all just doing a calorie deficit that are not really doing strict keto anymore. So if y'all would like to see options on that later in the week, let me know and I can show y'all a few options on that as well. Okay, so I got my bowl. So I substituted the breaded chicken for grilled chicken, and I took out the hash browns, and I just added extra chicken, egg, and it comes with cheese, and then you can add this salsa. And I will keep track of my macros because, like I said, usually on the Chick-fil-A app, when you substitute stuff, it actually gives you the right macros amount. So say I took out the hash browns, I could take it off the app and it'll subtract those calories, which I love. Their salsa is the bomb. See, and it just has egg, cheese, and your grilled chicken. And it's super good. It's gonna hit the spot right now because I'm super hungry. And if this just doesn't make you full, just add a protein shake later on. You know the chicken's good. So just a little quick breakfast option for y'all on the go if you don't feel like making breakfast at home. Alright guys, I am back home from Chick-fil-A. So,
before breakfast ends on their app. I went ahead and looked. Usually I can customize everything. Like, usually if I take something off my salad, it usually subtracts the macros. But for the breakfast bowl, it doesn't let you subtract the hash browns on the app. It does give you the calories for a grilled filet, so that's good. So we're gonna kind of ballpark I don't know why I have something stuck in my throat. We're gonna kind of ballpark our macros with breakfast, but honestly, it's low calorie even with the hash browns. So when you go to Chick-fil-A app, I did the hash brown scramble bowl with grilled filet. It does have the macros with the hash brown, but it only comes out to 420 calories per bowl. So we're just going to ballpark it. I took out the hash browns. I did add extra protein. I'm just going to do 400 calories, okay? Say we had 400 calories for our breakfast today, okay? So, I mean, this is real life. This is what I'm telling you. This is what I usually do. If I can't figure it out, but I have, like, an example of like where it can be around, I usually just add that. So we're gonna say we had 400 calories for breakfast, okay? And we can go ahead and just do that. So if I go ahead and I'm gonna quick entry my breakfast, since I really don't know, I'll just put Chick-fil-A bowl. The only thing is, like, I really don't have the exact macros for like my protein intake, but we'll still ballpark that as well. So let me see the protein intake for the bowl. It says that it is 31 grams of protein, so we'll just go ahead and add that, because I still want like a window of where I'm at for the day. I don't want to go over, so we'll just rough it today, okay? I will add my fat as well. See, the fat's gonna be off though. I'll put 20 grams of fat because it's 25. We'll do that. I think that's it, okay? We'll ballpark it, okay? Sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. So, say we had 400 calories so far, 31 grams of protein at least, because I did have two chickens and an extra egg, so we probably had about that. But I am gonna go ahead and drink a protein shake. I have my Premier protein shake on hand. The bowl hit the spot, but it didn't completely fill me up. It was just a little quick breakfast. So we're gonna go in with my Premier protein shake, and then I should be good till later on. Okay, I have the cafe latte flavor, 30 grams of protein right here, and it is 160 calories. So usually, like, if I eat breakfast, I try to stay within the 500 calorie window, usually for breakfast or lunch. It just depends. But yeah, we'll have some more meals later on. I'm gonna go ahead and drink this up. I'm gonna get ready for the day. I'm gonna go shower because I was a sweaty mess today in the gym, and then we'll be back later on. I just got out the shower, and usually when I get ready, I like to make myself a cup of coffee. So I've been using my Keurig. I've been buying different pods. I love to just try different coffees. So this one is a Folgers breakfast blend, and while I get ready, I'm just gonna sip on my coffee. We're just gonna do an 8 ounce today. And I've been switching out all of my coffee Halloween cups. This one right here is my favorite. I finally found the Poison Apple Disney mug. I have been looking for the cookie jar. I cannot find it anywhere. It's always sold out. I'm so disappointed. But at least I found the coffee mug. And it's so freaking cute. I love it. But it was $15. I've never paid $15 for a coffee mug. Usually, like, when I buy the ones at Marshall's, they're like $7, $4. This was $15, but I couldn't pass it up. I love it. I love Halloween everything. And if something stands out like this, like, if it's new, unique, and it stands out and, like, it's different, I'm all for it. So I finally got my hands on this one. For my sweetener, I keep some granular monk fruit sweetener for my coffee in here. I've been on the hunt for like little, it got wet. I put water on it. I need to dry it. But I've been on the hunt for like little Halloween scoops to go with the theme. If y'all couldn't tell right now, we absolutely love Halloween. In my last video, I showed y'all part of my room. My husband's been working nights, so we've been trying to like update it here and there. But I promise y'all, I will show y'all the whole room when everything is set up. I have my little... Look at this. Isn't this cute? I got this from Marshall's too. Okay, I've been going in with the silk creamer, the oat creamers. This one is the maple brown sugar one. Just add a splash. And this is going to be my coffee while I go ahead and finish getting ready for the day.
All
Alright guys, so it's been a little bit. I was at home doing some, I was actually recording a TikTok. If y'all don't follow me on TikTok, make sure y'all follow me. It's Keto with Sammy. So I was just doing a little work. I was hanging out with my husband because, you know, he's been working overnight. I haven't really got to spend much time with him. But picked up my kids from school. Now I'm headed to HEB. We're going to grab a few things for dinner. Today's a rainy day. It's very gloomy outside. So we're making another fall recipe for y'all. A soup recipe. We're going to be making some jalapeno popper soup. It's one of my favorites. It's so good. So we're going to pick up a few ingredients for that. But since my husband is going to work, he wanted me to grab him a quick little lunch before he leaves. So next to HEB, there is a Mod's Pizza. I'm going to be grabbing him a pizza, but I'm thinking about just getting a little mini salad. It doesn't hurt anything. All keto approved. So we're going to go ahead and grab a salad from Mod's. Okay, we need a green bell pepper for the soup. So I'm just going to grab a medium-sized one. And of course we need jalapenos, so these are pretty big. I'm just gonna grab 3 just in case. And I'm cheating again today, so I'm gonna grab a rotisserie chicken. They have only been having flavored rotisserie chickens lately. I found one, but I want 2. Okay, so I got 1 rotisserie chicken. I wanna make extra. Put this down here. My god, everybody's attacking the rotisserie chickens. You know why? Because they're cheaper right now than buying a whole pack of chicken. I want to add a little bit of extra chicken, so I'm just going to grab this little pack of the chicken drumsticks again and just add more. We just need a thing of cream cheese. I have most of the ingredients on hand at home. I just needed a few things. Last thing I need is just a bag of Monterey Jack cheese, but I like to get this Colby and Monterey Jack mix. Okay, I'm gonna grab a mini salad. They have, oh no, those aren't the dressings. They have dressings. I think I want to try the Zesty Roma because I've never tried that before and I believe it's keto approved because usually I get ranch. I don't know, maybe I'll get ranch. Usually I get ranch or Caesar, but Caesar has more calories, so we'll go with ranch. That's crazy how Caesar has more calories, right? Think for meats. Ooh, they have egg. I didn't even know they had egg here. What? I never see egg. Hi, can I have a Mod pizza and then a mini salad to go? Yeah. I'm gonna try not to go too crazy on the toppings, but I love pepperoni in my salad with spicy sausage. Okay. I just want the spring mix. That's what it is, right? The mix?
Yes.
With ranch. I want pepperonis and then spicy sausage. Yeah. And then I'll do diced tomatoes, cucumber, some cheese. And then just black olives. And that'll be it. No, I only like it on my salad.
I still stand by it.
You guys, I got my salad, and then I was trying to hold the drink, the pizza, and my salad at the same time, and I dropped my salad. I'm so sad. Look, RIP. But the guy remade it for me. He gave it to me, thankfully. He was nice. I was so sad. All right, guys, I'm back home. I had to hurry up because my husband has to go to work, but I got my salad. My second salad, you guys. He said it was his fault. He's like, I knew I should have put it in a bag for you. I was like, oh my god. I was walking out and like I had the box of pizza, I had a drink, and then I had my salad on top of the box of pizza, and I was like trying to unlock my truck, and it literally just like it rolled off and it just went pew, and I was like, and I was really not gonna go back in, but I was like, I want that salad. I was like, I have to go back in. So in my salad I got cucumber, tomato, black olives, the spring mix with some ranch, and then a little bit of mozzarella cheese, pepperoni, and spicy sausage. That's usually like the perfect mix I like to get. I'm gonna try to find the macros online because I know you can go to the mod app and customize your salad, so I'm pretty sure it'll give you the macros at the end. I love this size. This is a mini size. They do have a mod size, which is bigger, but if you have a mods near you, they have tons of options to mix different salads with. And then they do have a cauliflower crust there, but I wouldn't say that's keto. It's higher in carbs, so I would just say it's more of like on the lower, low carb side, if that makes sense. Does that make sense? They do have a cauliflower crust, okay? I just wouldn't say it's keto. But if you are looking for a healthier option in a crust pizza, they do have that there. All right, y'all, we are working on our last meal of the day. We're gonna go ahead and start up some dinner. So we're gonna be shredding up these rotisserie chickens. You can go in with one rotisserie chicken. I don't know, I might shred this up because this is a pretty good size rotisserie chicken. I might shred it up, see if it's a good amount for my soup. I just like extra chicken in my soup. And if it is, I'll just save this for another meal tomorrow or the next day or something, okay? But we're going to go ahead and start shredding a rotisserie chicken. You just want to add it to a bowl. Now, I do have a separate video on this recipe. If you just search Keto Wasami Jalapeno Popper Chicken Soup, it'll be at the in my playlist at the end of this video. I do make fresh chicken breast in that recipe, but lately, you guys, like I said, I just been loving convenience. I just been buying rotisserie chickens and just making easy meals, just trying to cut time in half as much as I can, because I tend to get super busy with things, you know, mom life and all that stuff. So it's just more convenient, but you can definitely make it using fresh chicken breast. Okay, so I just shredded up the one rotisserie chicken because it was actually a good size rotisserie chicken. I knew it felt a little bit heavier, but usually when I get rotisserie chickens, they don't have a lot of meat. Sometimes they'd be small, but that one was a good size. So we're going to go in with just one rotisserie chicken. Now what you want to do, we are going to go ahead and dice up half a large onion. I have my green bell pepper that we're going to dice up. And then we're also going to dice up, we're going to dice up two of these large jalapenos. And then I'm going to save the, oh my God, these are going to be spicy. I can already like hit my throat and I haven't even chopped into it. Anyways, we're going to chop up two of the large jalapenos and then we're going to save the other one for topping. So yeah, let's go ahead and do that. With the jalapenos, you can either keep the seeds in or you could take them out. It depends if you like it spicy. I'm just going to go ahead and keep mine in because I like my jalapeno popper soup with a little kick. Okay, now for this recipe, we are going in with our Instant Pot. But you can make this recipe over the stovetop as well in a pot. It all just depends how you want to do it, okay? So I hit the saute mode on my Instant Pot. And we're going to go ahead and melt two tablespoons of butter down. And then we're going to add in what we just chopped. You're going to go ahead and add in all the jalapenos, onion, and green bell pepper that we just chopped up. Be careful not to breathe it in if you left the seeds in the jalapenos. You're going to go ahead and start seasoning this. We're going to give this a few minutes to get tender and cook down. I seasoned with some salt. Of course, some pepper. I'm trying not to talk over this. It'll make me cough. Some pepper. Oh, you could add fresh. You can add fresh garlic. Woo! Okay, wear a gas mask. You can chop in fresh garlic, but I'm gonna add in this minced garlic. Oh my God. A little bit of paprika. And then you're gonna go in with some ground comino. And then just give this about 5 minutes to cook down and just stir it about every minute so nothing burns. Okay, it has been cooking down for about 5 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and click cancel. Okay, once you turn that off, since I'm using rotisserie chicken, this isn't gonna take long at all, but if you're using fresh chicken breast, you're gonna go ahead and add it in right now. I'm only gonna cook this, pressure cook it for 5 minutes, but if you were adding chicken breast fresh, you're gonna pressure cook it for 15 minutes. Dion's over here, he went running, he's all nasty. It's sweaty. He's waiting in the kitchen again.
I'm hungry again.
Okay, so once you have your chicken, remember your Instant Pot always needs a liquid, so you're gonna go in with 3 cups of chicken broth. We're gonna go ahead and seal it after you add in your chicken broth.
If you're doing fresh chicken, do 15 minutes, but I'm going to go ahead and pressure cook it for 5 minutes just so all the seasoning and all the flavor can come together. In the meanwhile, while this pressure cooks, we're going to go ahead and chop up some bacon and get that nice and crispy so we can put it on top of the soup. You guys, okay, I forgot the bacon. I don't know how I added it to my list. I swear I added it to my list and I didn't save. So, we're having jalapeno chicken soup.
Disgusting.
Without the popper. I'm so mad. I'm so mad, okay? But it'll still be good. If you're making this recipe, add bacon. Bash wants to say hi. You guys, I'm so mad that I forgot the bacon. Like, that's like one of the main ingredients to the soup. I've never forgotten an ingredient like that, okay? But like I said, if you were adding the bacon, you would let this come to pressure cook. You could watch my other video, but you would crisp it right now. Then in a little bit, you would add half of the bacon to the soup and mix it in. And then you would use the other half to top the soup with. But it's okay. It's okay. Still gonna taste good.
Okay, once it's done pressure cooking, you let out all the pressure. Whoops, sorry guys. It's gonna get a little steamy. But once you let out the pressure, you're gonna give everything a good mix. And then we're gonna go ahead and add in our cheeses.
Okay, so to your chicken, you're gonna add in 8 ounces of softened cream cheese. Or I mean, is it 6 ounces? 6 ounces of softened cream cheese. Then this is where you would add half of your crispy bacon. Then you're gonna add in half a cup of some heavy cream. Then we're going in with 2 cheeses. You're gonna add in 3/4 cup of mild cheddar cheese, 3/4 cup of Monterey Jack cheese, but I have a Colby mix. And then you're gonna save some for topping of your soup.
Okay, once you have your cheeses in here, you're gonna click saute mode again, just so you can melt everything in a little bit better. And you're just gonna keep mixing it until all the cheese is well dissolved into the chicken. Okay, once you're done, it should be nice and creamy like this. Now we're gonna serve it in our bowl, and then you just wanna top it off.
I gotta serve up my sad jalapeno popper soup with no bacon. I am so upset. Because the bacon just adds like that flavor to it. But it's okay, it's still gonna be good. It's just gonna be a basic soup though. Okay, so at this point, you could top it off with crispy bacon, some more cheese, and you could put fresh jalapenos, but honestly, I'm just gonna leave it like this. I have a good amount of cheese in here, I have a good amount of jalapenos, and I don't have bacon. It's a sad day, but this will do. If y'all happen to try these with the fresh, cool days coming up, you guys, Dion just told me that we're about to hit the 70s this week. I'm so excited. Let me know what y'all think about this recipe. Make it the right way with the bacon. It's delicious. It's still so good though. It's still so good. Anybody else have to eat their food like super hot? I have to eat my food super hot. Even though I know it's really hot, like I have to eat it. If it cools down slightly, I don't want to eat it. So I'm weird. But anyways, I'm gonna sit down, enjoy my last meal of the day, and I'll try to tell you all the macros for the end of the day. I'm gonna try to calculate everything. We'll be back shortly. All right guys, sorry I look rough. Okay, I ended up taking the shower. I was like hot. I had to get my boys down for bed. So yeah, but we ate dinner and it was really good. I ate a serving size, got me nice and full. It would have been better with bacon, but it still hit the spot. It was so good, okay? So I roughly calculated just my calorie intake today because I couldn't really find out my protein intake, but I'm pretty sure I hit my protein goal. So I was actually able to find out my macros for my mod salad. So I went on their app and I created my own mini salad. I added everything in my salad that I had put on there, and then it gave me the total calorie count for my salad, but it doesn't give you like your protein count and all that stuff. So I just went ahead and calculated my calories. So that for that mini salad was 335 calories. Then for our soup, it was 571 calories. So we stayed in our calorie deficit to go. Today we had Chick-fil-A this morning, our breakfast bowl. We had a protein shake with that. Then we had a mod salad for lunch and our soup for dinner. So we got 3 meals in pretty much, and we stayed in our calorie deficit goal. So my calorie deficit intake daily is 1,522 calories, and we got 1,466 calories in today. So we did awesome, okay? I still try to track the best that I can. I'm just trying to show y'all that you could still track, even though it's kind of hard with to-go foods. At least try to get your calorie intake, like what your calorie is for the meal, at least that. If you can't find out the protein, at least try to rough estimate so you have your window, so you're still staying in your calorie deficit as best as you can. But I'm going to go ahead and end my day, you guys. We had an awesome simple day of eating. Honestly, it was just a simple day today. I really didn't do much, but I still ate awesome and I still stayed on track. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next one. If you're here